We've got
the rest of the year to visit there and stop.
Yeah, we haven't been there a lot, but at least we've got a good area. Alright, must have been wrong gear. And we'll have to put up and listen to that sound now, I suppose.
Just start the video from here.
Wow! That stopped. The engine light went off then, and the engine's on. Wow.
Yeah.
We are recording, aren't we? Since I just hate seeing it.
V-Power Nitro Plus
2. Oh, that's natural benefit. No. Okay, well, we're now showing down the announce screen. Is annoying. I'll have to put up with it, so I can't get rid of it.
The phone can only provide you
USB.
West Brom in the quarterfinal. Sherwood's rejuvenated Villa stormed to a 2-0 victory in a match that was marred by pitch invasions before and after the full-time whistle. Here's Zogbia making his way towards the edge of the box, and Zogbia left footed across the edge of the air. It's Fabian Dell!
He plays better on the right.
That's all it is.
If you give him enough opportunities and give him enough confidence and give him enough games as a centre forward, if you like. I think that he can work very well for you, but the backup has to be really good. And they don't come much better than Ozil and Alexis Sanchez.
Yeah,
they can get behind the one from what I remember 10 years ago. All season.
I came through it because of a Tom Goodell storytelling.
Don't forget Ron Flowers in the World Cup team of the year.
Do need to set
it's
up
just
again, but
silly mistakes. They get it. Little 5 or 6 yard passes. They try to filter into midfield. They get to cut out. And then all of a sudden they're on the back.
Maybe it's still doing it.
The actual shape, when you look at teams that are well organised, well disciplined, Tony Pulis back four, Jose Mourinho back four. Villa never give you that kind of cohesion. You have players running out of position. Bakuna, more or less a right-sided midfielder, they're a right back. They've got to condense space today, get the heads down over the ball of a lot of the Arsenal players, deny time and space, which they did against Liverpool quite well, and then look to hit on the counter-attack.
Really driving day today, isn't it?
Around
we're
the
really
back as they've done, and making
really
many individual mistakes that they have picked off.
Stan Collymore, more from Stuart Pearce as well in just a moment. First though, across town to West London, he's taken a bath against Saracens, Aviva Premiership final. Full time.
Thanks,
the season done and dusted with Saracens.
No, don't make it sound like I'm being hypocritical. No, just as a prompt before, we're trying to fix a camera. Trying to fix a camera through a window.
Saracens did hard work in the first half, leading 25-3 in the interval. Thanks to tries from Jamie George, Chris.
Mike's just filming the journey.
Three penalties and two conversions as well. Farrell named the Aviva man of the match. Bath were a pale shadow of themselves in the regular season until the second half. They came back hard with a try from Jonathan Joseph.
It's usually three for £7 and £2.60.
But Sarri's again edged away, ran down the
Okay, by the way, there's a count on us, low fat variety. There's another variety. It's the main type that I typically get.
Russell, thank you very much indeed.
No, I get some of each, but they're separate, you see what I mean.
In goal, a back four, Alan Hutton.
You can't get three for to get the discount and get some of each. You've got to get all of them.
Delph cleverly, the central midfielders.
Or just three at one,
Grealish, I would imagine that will patrol from the left-hand side. They've just
I think the packaging's sort of a whitish, creamish colour. And you get ravioli and struck mushroom. You get macaroni cheese and all that sort of thing with it as well. Okay, yeah. They're all the other things that are in the same section. It's just orange ravioli. It's not a low fat, it's just Stella touch. Right, thank you. Right, bye. What time are you back? No, don't get the low fat, get the normal side. What time is it?
Concentration and make sure often when you're attacking
you're going to stay out, are you? Okay.
So
you're going to stay out until you pick them up. Probably about 5 o'clock.
Like, all of a sudden they've got the ball, they're in possession of the ball, and you think they're nice and safe.
Just biscuits each,
space, then, and as soon as that ball gets turned over, if you're slightly out of shape, that's when they catch you out. Normally, when the opposition
happens, you'll be on the
way.
You've got the team here now.
Yeah.
seconds. Got to go into Chester.
Skip to the direction today. It's obviously Bellerin and Monreal like to get forward. They can both go forward now. 5 or 6 times in a half.
I forgot to say, Mum said she's picking through
their own portion of the pitch. It might be one ball, it might be two balls. I think this particularly well against Liverpool. They nick the ball off Liverpool's midfielders. Liverpool's fullbacks have pushed forward. Then you utilise the pace.
Well, I just can see Pegfish cast from here. And also at least I can see them from this far away.
I think the change since Tim's come in with this team and the real strength of Aston Villa, they've got energy. They've got energy in Delph, they've got energy in Benteke and Zogbia, and Bonlamor when he comes on cleverly. All of these players have got great energy, and that's the one thing. Their Achilles heel definitely is the scenario at the back. I think even when they were the lowest goal scorers in the Premier League, that weren't their problem up front for me. It was what was going on with their back four, their goalkeeper.
Ref side, he started in third.
How ambitious will they be early on? Because against Liverpool here, they were. They were the ones that set the tempo for that semi-final.
When they were here for the playoff final last week,
this was driving the whole time.
I mean, Middlesbrough came here, and I thought they looked really flat and devoid of mental energy.
Actually, we did it earlier in the year, that's just what you should do.
Not had a great night's sleep, because it's a big deal for a lot of players. You know, some players will have gone to bed last night and slept like a baby. Some will be replaying themselves, lifting the cup, scoring the winning goal. So that depends on, from that perspective, Arsenal have already won it. The players can come out, they're playing well towards the end of the season. The one thing that they were very impressive with, and the skipper mentions it there about their energy,
They showed it to Chester City Centre, and that was probably the 10 past 5 at the time, 15 minutes left. Well, I don't know how much space is on there in terms of 5 gig, but I think you can get away with like pressing it one more time, maybe it just takes a lot of
time. And you're losing 3-2. Is it what they need to do today? Is exactly what they did against Liverpool. Is get the opportunity to keep Benteke involved in the game, but screen and protect the back four. Because, in all honesty, I mentioned the stat there, 10 goals for Arsenal in the last 3 games here to Villa's 1, they've played each other. Is that could accurately bring be repeated today in terms of a 3 or 4 nil scoreline if Villa don't defend very well. So it's really up to Florin Okore, Kieran Richardson at left fullback, and Alan Hutton, who's a very good right fullback this day, to have their shape right. If they give Villa that kind of platform moving forward, they can go on and cause problems. If in the first 5 or 6 minutes Arsenal have asked 3 or 4 questions, then Villa will start to get a little bit jittery, a little bit nervous, and it's one way traffic.
Stan Collymore and Stuart Pearce alongside me here for Talk Sport. Jim Proudfoot is our commentator. Ian Danton will be pitch side for us as well. What are we? Just under an hour from kickoff here at Wembley. It's cup final day, and it's Arsenal against Aston Villa.
Tried to take it this week, but
it's not on there.
No, I think we got rid of it in a freak situation because it wasn't by the stall.
It just suddenly occurred in the middle of the journey. I think when I stopped the ignition to pick up something, then didn't then put it back in. It didn't come on again. I've never seen it since.
Oh, right. Immensely to a garage.
I think about this car 6 years. I think I might have seen it 3 times.
Yeah.
But only once in about the past 3 years.
So what is their equipment? They can tell you why it went on and by
this. It's not usually serious when it comes on.
It's not usually all that serious, but it's like a series of codes or something.
I've heard people say their engine light's always on, but they just drive with it anyway because it's not a problem.
Yeah, but if that happens, it will eventually break down, apparently. So if it's just always on all the time, it will at some point. Because that's what happened with the Ford KA, so I'm not doing that again, but I am getting them to check in all that. Jackson, high acting, and stores of the post-apocalyptic wasteland that is.
Parts.
Well, not for Germany. It'd be funnier what I did if I just opened the door and tipped it out, put all of it
onto a bike car,
onto this. Yeah. Oh god, I hate to see that. And then the car started driving over it. Opened the door and shot it out. Oh, hasn't stopped, has it?
No, we've got 7.5 minutes left.
Let's hit in 7.5.
You might get two. You might get two.
You might want to take a picture of this with your camera. You can see my old bamba there. I could on mine, but I can't.
The resolution might be good enough on this. But the other camera would.
Yeah, well, I can get it. Very risky thing to do. I could just zoom in momentarily on the video.
That's good. Yeah, you've got it. Yeah.
17.9.
No, don't go any more. It's going off the... Leave it there.
Yeah, but I don't want
to... Pause it, just don't... No,
leave it... Wait, press the button.
Leave it there for 10 seconds.
I've got a picture, press the button.
Yeah, it's just doing it, so it's on a timer.
I've got to take it out of Zoom as soon as you leave. Back to 2-2. I'm preparing now, it's going to change.
I don't know what it means, 5 out of 6.
Trust me, we've got a picture. And this is illegal, sadly.
What's illegal?
Messing with the bloody equipment in the car.
Still red. Right, get ready.
That's the thing. If there's a cop there, he can get stopped.
Six and a half minutes to go. You'll probably get two, but not necessarily through the city centre in that time.
Yeah, that'll do, because that'll be a natural point on the video. Now the light's off. But do you think this car is driving badly here?
No.
It is.
Not really, no. It's not shoveling, is it? You're not struggling to accelerate.
It's the best car we've ever had, even if it did.
You think you could make a difference back in this?
You're far more likely to. You need to try and stop this light coming on.
I meant. Say in a month or two.
Oh, yeah, well, I reckon there's some friends there as well as Peter, so drop in on them. Yeah, he's dealt with Thomas today.
Scored against Villa in February. He makes today only his 7th start of the season, but 6 goals in those 6 starts so far. So no place for Olivier Giroud.
How about insurance? You know, not insurance. Breakdown coverage, you have it.
It's still on the RAC, so yeah.
You
still have to pay for it.
No, but what is it? Is it cover home start and all the rest of it? Or just the roadside?
Probably just the roadside. That's better than that. It's home start where they take it back. Of Christian
Benteke, who today home start is where it's the problem where you live getting started again. But if you leave your car over a quarter of a mile away, you can get round it anyway. Because the home start only involves problems with the vehicle within a quarter of a mile to your address.
Have you got a home start?
At the moment, yeah, I think I have, but I'm not paid £153. I'm paying that. I'm changing it to a cheaper premium.
Yeah. I'm sure I'll be all right now. Stuart, actually, putting your managerial 20 minutes, we'll do it.
Just me, I can hear some sort of...
Yeah, it's doing it on navigation.
It sounds like...
Yeah, it's doing it. Get it through. 5:30 is a difficult time
for a player... on an occasion like this, in a way, you can perhaps
four
minutes to go.
Mouse, don't
get your afternoon sleep as you would do for an evening game.
And I don't have want you. To, I'll have to check the oil.
Has to sort of not rein them back in, but make sure that they're ready by the time we get to kick off.
Oh, yeah, there's a new like bike store.
Really, Sagas. One, you hope that the heat
one that's next to here is like
it's going to be a warm, muggy day.
Brought here, there's another one.
But the other side,
oh, yeah, the bike factory. I do still want a new bike, but
there was a Waitrose.
I ought to get that one repaired or something. Probably
get some sleep after a little stretch of the legs in the morning. And it's a really strange time if you will,
because we're on the right for a match.
So you need to make a right soon. Well, let's worst hear
from Ian Danter, our next fourth ride. Man of the team, who's pitch side, and he's caught up with Hector.
Line-up takeaway.
That's the most important thing to that. So far as we mean...
Heaven cycles, there it is.
Yeah, it's gonna wipe the floor with the bike factory, which is a bit unfair, I guess.
Hector, what do you make of this place?
I think if I do get a new bike, I'll get it from the bike factory. This has got water and place that's on the other side in Wales a bit.
What did the FA Cup final mean to you as a boy growing up back in Spain?
Well, for me as a little boy in Barcelona,
it's still hanging on.
Much to it, but once you come to
England, we went to an Atos medical here.
How big it is for them, you know, and for the country and for the club. It just changes your mind and just makes you feel like one of them, and we just wanna win it.
Does the performances against Aston Villa in the league, do they count for anything, do you think, this afternoon?
Well, this is the FA Cup final, you know.
Apparently
it
can, but has it been? Maybe the GPS is not.
They're going to go for it as we are, and it's going to be a really tough game, we know that. And then we're all ready for it.
Whatever happens today,
has
this season been more than you could have expected?
Yeah, no, it used to have in cities or whatever,
you know, really. It's been something that I would have never expected, you know. It's been a great season for me, however this ends.
How many minutes now?
We've got 2 minutes left.
Hector Bella in there with TalkSport. See, and Dan, you can tell you
I'm trying to think the best way to go from here.
It's
1-1.
One now.
Show that, yeah, because we haven't been that way before.
So you're going over the railway bridge.
Just for safety now.
We might just about make it to the railway bridge.
Should we just press start and stop?
No, let it go to the 25. No, let it go to the 25.
No, because